Capital One Venture X business card. With no preset spending limit, Chris can buy the materials his business...
this might interest you, but people ask me, how did you lose so much weight?
I thought some time alone was what we really needed. You said this time would do more than it helped, but I couldn't see that. I thought it was the end of a beautiful story, and so I left the one I love.
You got your brand new weave on. You got your new outfit on. you think you all that in a bag of chips, but you got doo-doo between your tongue. And I don't care how well you look, I don't care even when you walk into the bank to get yourself some money out the bank, if you got doo-doo on your toes, you gonna stink.
All right now.
And everybody will know that you're a stinker because doo-doo just smells. But all you got to do now is call on Jesus and let Jesus wash your feet. Let me close this thing. This
51st. This is Thaddeus Matthews, a.k.a. the Cussing Pastor. And I'm inviting you each and every Sunday morning to join me for virtual worship. That's right. You can worship without leaving home. Every Sunday morning on my YouTube channel, just put in Thaddeus Matthews at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time and listen to the word of God that he's given me to give you. I'm looking for you on this Sunday morning on my YouTube channel from my virtual studios, which is my virtual church, The Naked Truth, Liberation, and Empowerment Ministries. Join me.
It's the first year anniversary celebration for Bishop Stapleton and Friends. Easter Sunday, March 31st at 3 p.m. featuring So Amazing of St. Louis, Calvin Delights, Grace of Jackson, Tennessee, The Highway Harmonizers, God Sent, Lil Chris and Reunited, The Gospel Writers of Jonesboro, Arkansas, New Direction, The Brown Four, Lady Jeanette Bethany, and many more. Make sure you save the date. Easter Sunday, Bishop Stapleton and Friends, first year anniversary celebration, March 31st, 2024.
Doors open at 2 p.m.
Program starts at 3 p.m. Greater Bethel, Church of God in Christ, 1672. Memphis, Tennessee.
$10 in advance.
$15 at the door.
$25 special VIP and souvenir.
Come one, come all. Easter Sunday and help celebrate Bishop Stapleton and Friends. First year anniversary celebration. Be there.
With Open Heart Community Foundation. Do you have loved ones that you're not able to take care of? Do you need somewhere for them to go and can't afford for them somewhere to go? We are providers for the State of Tennessee Choices Program. We take United Healthcare and we also take Amerigroup, which is now WellPoint. If you need someone to help you out, contact me, 901-409-1228.
The biggest hazard to Memphis drivers other than car-to-car collisions is potholes. Well, you need a tire. You need to go to Tri-State Tire Wholesale located at 3278 Democrat Road at American Way. They specialize in new and used tires. I don't care what it is that you drive, whether it's a car, a truck, tractor in the field, a motorcycle, SUV, or a semi-truck, Tri-State Tire Wholesale has the tire or tires for you at the best price in the Mid-South area. Every brand known to man is carried at Tri-State Tire Wholesale. Don't look anywhere else. Tri-State Tire Wholesale, 3278 Democrat Road at American Way. Call them at 901-795-0707. 901-795-0707.
Are you looking for a place to go?
on the weekends other than the club? Well, let me tell you about the newest hottest spot in town, and it's Martha's Daiquiri Factory, located at 8553 Macon in Cordova. Look, they have over 140 daiquiris. That's right, over 140 daiquiris. Plus, they got good food also. Look, you get daiquiris like the Drunk Jack Frost. The Pink Starburst Strawberry Hennessy. The Lemon Drop Mango Whiskey Sour. Jungle Juice. And my favorite, and we're going to call it the Cuffing Pastor Special. It's called Hideous Motherfucker. If you're tired of the kiddie atmosphere and you're grown and you want to be in a grown person's atmosphere, Martha's Daiquiri Factory is a place for you to be. Weekends, they've got big flat screen TVs. They've got a live disc jockey. They've got food. Martha's Daiquiri Factory, 8553 Macon in Cordova.
When death comes to your family and you're left in charge of putting together a celebration of life program, you want that program to be memorable, beautiful, and to project the marvelous life that your loved one lived. Well, for your funeral program, you don't have to search or look around. You just need to call the Obituary Queen, Dee Ferris of Ferris Media and Marketing and Alpha Omega Monuments. Dee takes pride in special design and production of your loved one's memorable program. After the funeral and your loved one is buried and you want that burial spot to be memorialized forever, call Dee for your monument. Dee Ferris and Ferris Media and Marketing Management can take care of all of your print needs, both church and professional, and anything that you need, Dee can get it done. You're looking for a graphic expert? Call Dee at 901-440-6643. That's 901-440-6643. Or go by 2960 Chelsea at Wofford.
Good evening, good evening, good evening, good evening. I'm the one and only, I'm Thaddeus Matthews. On a Friday night here, on the most controversial show in Memphis, Mid-South, and anywhere else where I'm pulling no punches. Just tell it like it is. We've had about 12 shootings in Memphis in the last 3 days.
12. Tonight, I want to talk about one of the shootings where a woman is a grown-ass woman is dead. Okay? She's dead. Killed by a 42-year-old man, Jayon Davis, in South Memphis. Two people have been arrested in this shooting in South Memphis that took place on yesterday. They left one woman dead, two others injured. Jayon Davis, 42, was charged with first-degree murder in the woman's death, while 20-year-old Destiny Plummer is accused of shooting at Davis after he allegedly shot her mother. The shooting was reported around 6:45 yesterday on Quinn near South Parkway and Wilson. The girl was hospitalized with critical injuries, is what police said. Court documents allege that the shooting stemmed from a street fight in front of a home on Quinn Avenue involving children and a woman later identified as Tamara Plummer. Davis, whose daughters were part of the melee or fight, told investigators that he confronted Plummer before walking away. He then got a gun from someone before he went back to Plummer and shot her at least 3 times. However, according to court records, investigators found security footage showing that he walked to his SUV in his driveway across the street to get a handgun before he walked towards Plummer in a straight, aggressive manner and shot her. Police said that the woman died at the scene. According to court documents, Davis is a convicted felon who was sentenced to 30 months in prison for aggravated assault in October 2016 in Kansas City. Records also show that her mother was shot. Destiny Plummer fired shots at Davis. The gunfire struck two other people, is what the records showing. The younger Plummer told investigators that she had a gun, but it went off by accident. I guess 4, 5, 6 times it went off by accident. She has been charged with reckless endangerment with a deadly weapon, records show. Well, I put the video on Facebook. Facebook put me in in the jail, Facebook jail, for a week. And, you know, I found that hard with all the videos of black folk fighting that Facebook allowed to be on their page. I think they just pick at me. But I got the video here. They can't do nothing about the video here. You want to see it, and you're going to see that the little 20-year-old girl who had children in this fight, along with Davis's children in the fight, did not accidentally shoot at him. She shot 3, 4, 5 times.
See them? There they go. No fighters on. Mm-hmm. Don't break them up now. Let them fight. Let them fight. Don't mess.
You got a pistol. Everyone got a pistol.
Mama got a pistol out there with some kids. See? Mess ass shit. Mess as fuck.
He got a pistol too.
Everybody got a pistol. They just as messy as fuck. Messy as fuck. Messy as fuck. And here come one with a sword. I guess that's a sword. Oh, machine. Mm-hmm. They mess his fuck.
Hey, shot him, bro. Dude shot him, man. He killed him. He killed the girl.
Mess his fuck. Mess his fuck. They all just mess his fuck.
Now, I counted 10 to 12 shots that accidentally went off. Okay. 10 to 12 accidental shots. What have we as a people become? Yeah. What have we become? See, you can't blame this behavior on Paul Young. You can't blame it on C.J. Davis. You blame this on ratchet as mammies. Why is it that grown folk find themselves in children shit? Here was the mom with her big old ass, with a pistol in her back. Instead of trying to break up the fight, she a hype man. Yeah, you can't blame it on a white man either. Thank you for somebody saying that. You can't blame the white man. The white man looks at you now, niggas, and says, Lord have mercy, we shall hung all of their asses. And Mr. White Man, I agree with you. A lot of these niggas you should hung. Burn them at the stake. Because they become witches and warlocks and demons in our community. So don't blame the mayor. Don't blame C.J. Davis. Don't blame the police department. Y'all didn't send a note to C.J. and to the precinct, the South Precinct, tell them that y'all finna act a fool. Now, her ass is dead. Janone or whatever his Davis going to prison for the rest of his life. He had children out there fighting. They're gonna lose their daddy. The little girl that told police she accidentally shot at Davis when the prosecutors looked at the video, they're gonna find that there was at least 10 shots that was fired. Let's look at it again.
See that? There they go. The fight is on. Don't break them up now. Let them fight. Let them fight. Don't mess with them.
Everyone got a pistol.
Mama got a post out there with some kids. See? Mess ass shit. Mess as fuck.
He got a pistol too.
Everybody got a pistol. They just as messy as fuck. Mess as fuck. Mess as fuck. And here come one with a sword. I guess that's a sword. Machine. They mess his fuck.
Hey, Simon, dude, Simon, man. He killed that girl.
Mess his fuck. Mess his fuck. Hey, I'll just mess his fuck.
I counted at least 10 to 12 shots. But that woman, Tamara, whatever her name is, she's dead because she killed herself. She committed suicide. And see, there are parents that get in their children's shit. Whatever the fight was about, it ain't worth being dead. Dead is for a long time. Probably ain't got no goddamn insurance. Probably won't. Or GoFundMe, gonna be selling chicken plates and spaghetti plates. That's, you know, security is, I have made with the security for going to North Memphis and opening up a church. I'm going to have armed, tactful security. I'm going to have two security persons. One outside, dressed intact, with an AK-47, 57, whatever it is, have another guard on the inside, because number one, I know who I am, and I know sometimes people come for me, plus I don't want any calls or anything of that nature bothered with. So Naked Truth is going to go through the expense of making sure that we are protected, and those that come to our 10 o'clock morning worship are protected. No, original. It can't be rule justifiable. It's going to be premeditated. He might have gotten away with manslaughter. Had he not walked off, got a pistol, and came back, he could have got manslaughter. Some dummy on here said the daughter should not be charged, period. You're a motherfucking liar. She's 20 years old. At the point that her mama got unalived, there was no need to pick up a weapon. And 9 times out of 10, she picked up the gun that her mama had. She mad because her mama done been taken unalive. So she gonna shoot. We are in the dark ages in Memphis. Why do you mamas get involved? Why didn't this mother, Tamara, somebody said stay. Sister, you're a child for what? Are you serious? She was defending herself and her mom. No, she wasn't. No. No. She was not T-Stacks or whatever the fuck your name is. She was not protecting her mama. Her mama was laying on the motherfucking ground, deceased. Dead. Graveyard fertilizer. So she wasn't defending her mama. Her mama was dead. If it hadn't been for her, her mama wouldn't be dead. Shit. Her mama gets dead. She grabs the gun that the mama had and starts shooting. She starts shooting at the man that shot her mama. The nigga had the long sword or butcher knife or whatever the fuck it was. See, reckless, they give her a reckless charge. This is deep in the hood. Queen and Golden. What about Hamilton High School? And the mama had the gun in her hand when she got shot. So she had to go, oh, mama, what a gun at? What? I know you did, but I need the gun. So I said she got aim and skills. No, she ain't got no skills because she didn't hit no motherfucker. Let's look at it one more time. Just the last time.
See that? There they go.
Now look at that.
Don't break them up now. Let them fight. Let them fight. Don't mess with them.
Look at a pistol.
Mama got a pussy out there with some kids. See? Messy ass shit.
Mm-hmm.
Messy as fuck.
Yeah,
he got a pussy too.
Everybody got a pussy. They just as messy as fuck. Messy as fuck. Messy as fuck. And here comes one with a sword. I guess that's a sword. Oh, machine. Mm-hmm. And miss his fuck.
That was a good shot.
Dude shot him, man. He killed him. He killed that girl.
Miss his fuck. Miss his fuck.
Don't you?
Y'all just miss his fuck.
The man said, we told you she was high. This was living in the ghetto, get your ass. And see, you used to get mad, or you in the upper hood. You too good for us. Yes. You niggas don't know how to act in the hood. The white folk been scared of y'all. Now those good niggas, we scared of you niggas too. Shit. Wretched ass. I don't feel sorry for him. I don't. I don't even feel sorry for the dead woman. Because she don't have to be dead. She can be frying some fish this evening and some spaghettis. Okay. Fixing all them little never-head ass children some ramen noodles or something. She didn't have to be dead. She chose the life that she that kills her. You live by the streets, the streets will claim your ass. What are the black churches doing in the community these days? The children need them. No. It ain't the church's responsibility. It didn't say churches raise up the children in the way that they go, they should go. It says parents raise a child in the way that he should go. Not the church, not the preacher, not the deacon, not the choir member. It's your responsibility. And see, quit this shit. I hate hearing niggas talk about this shit. It takes a village. No, it don't. It wasn't a village that fucked you and got you pregnant. Shit. Quit blaming it on everybody else. But who you supposed to blame it on? These ignorant, nappy-headed, ratchet-ass mammies that's having these motherfucking babies. That girl that did the shooting, 20 years old, and got children in the fight? Goddamn, when you start having children? When you was 10? Damn, bitch! And we as black folk, we accept that shit. Damn. It's your responsibility. It's when the church will be back up and running. I'll feed you. I'll get you some groceries. But when it comes to school time, we ain't passing out no paper, no pencil, no pamphlets, no shit. Give you shit for no school. If you're 20 years old and you already got babies or children old enough to be in the goddamn streets fighting, bitch, you don't need nothing. Probably but a motherfucking job. I bet you get jobless. Man, we are so desensitized to all the killing in the black community that we'd rather record it and give our dialogue than call the police. I haven't seen anything about the young lady having a baby involved in the fight. Read the news script, man. And it will say that she had children involved in the melee. Your little girl's fucking too early. You ain't teaching them to save their pussies. These little girls are giving pussy to anybody that wants some pussy. The teachers, the principals, the coaches, Ned the Wino. But many of you as mamas are responsible for the death and destruction of your children. Well, he got a daddy too. You the motherfucker didn't want you when he was fucking you out behind the Alley House. So how the fuck he gonna want the baby? It's crazy. It's crazy what we have as a people. Have turned to. Nobody said anything about, get your little asses in the house. Go on. Street light finna come on. Go on in the house. What none of that? What none of that? If you don't stop that, I'm gonna whoop your ass. What none of that? What none? I done taught you better than that. Get your monkey ass in the goddamn house. What none of that? Got skull and bugs all over your goddamn head. Bitch, and you got the nerve to be out in the public fighting? Well, if the dad was here to help me, he ain't never been there to help you. Why he need to start helping you now? You gonna let them little wild, monkey-looking motherfuckers just go wild? Now you want the daddy. I need him to come help me. It's a shame. Somebody said, family, my baby Tam Tam, not only one life you took two, she was pregnant. So hard to say goodbye. I know you with God. How you know she with God? Shit. You will be truly missed. I've been talking to you every day on the phone. Did not have no idea this will be the last time, baby. You the jack of all trades, and there was nothing to you could not guess. So she was pregnant. Well, that's a little monster that won't be roaming the streets. It's dead too. down and put the motherfucker in heaven. She probably in J-Fold. Now, that's probably where she at. On that back hall in the mall. And that's where she probably is. All black men should get fast coming, whatever it is, to prevent issues like this from happening. No. Need to quit fucking these bitches. That ain't got no pride in themselves. They just got their legs open and get some pussy. Pussy, pussy, pussy. Anybody want any pussy today? We are a sad people. I can't come on back on Facebook to Friday, but I even appealed it and they wouldn't let me back. Sometimes I'll appeal it. Some pussy, and black men have to learn this. All black pussy, you ain't supposed to have your black in your ass in it. Some black pussies got that STD call, don't you get this, this gonna fuck you up. Yeah, it's worse than AIDS, the chlamydias, the herpes. Somebody said they saw a GoFundMe already up. Throw that bitch out in the backyard. Shit. Buried a hole right there in the front yard where she died at. She wanted to die. She want to be a ratchet hood motherfucker. Bury her ass in the hood. This is just crazy. When you, them things you saying, show is harsh for a preacher to be saying. Every preacher need to be telling you this. Every preacher should have this for a sermon on Sunday morning. And the reason is, he's scared of you. You ain't gonna say amen to this. But I preach this on a Sunday morning at Naked Truth. Title of the sermon today is Niggas Ain't Shit. Can I get an amen? Yeah, that's a good title. Niggas Ain't Shit. Will you go with me on this Sunday morning as I tell you that niggas ain't shit? Young niggas and old niggas and fat niggas and skinny niggas, educated niggas, dumb ass niggas, they ain't shit. Lord have mercy, this morning. And y'all be thinking that God is pleased with the nigger. No. You out there fighting with a gun and you pregnant? Well, that's why little bastard, we ain't gotta worry about carjacking. Breaking into shit. He dead with his mama. I know if that little baby in her stomach could talk tonight, he tell her, mama, why you so crazy? I was looking forward to living and you being a fool. I ain't gonna never have no Air Jordans. I ain't gonna never be no rapper. I ain't gonna never be no carjacker, no robber, no rapist. Lord have mercy. Wait a minute. I preach it on something. Somebody by the name of Jimmy Burchett done put together a GoFundMe. Thanks for all the prayers. Y'all, I'm so sorry I can't get to everyone. If you want to help my family out here, here's the link. Send me the link, whoever you are sending me, so I can see how much money they asking for. Jeez, what y'all rolling for? Y'all just having babies and y'all having these little monkey monsters turning them loose. These little children of the comb. Hey, Malcolm. What was the fight about? Any of you family members want to talk to me? Huh? Y'all be wanting to talk to me. You mean you can have a whole bunch of children and you ain't got no insurance? Roselle Joy, Paul Young need to step up before these immigrants get here with. Roselle, bitch, you crazy. You think the immigrants fault? Somebody said, you know South Memphis is gonna be mad at you. Man, that lady was love. You talking about her like that. I ain't saying nothing but the truth. Tell her what I lied about. It was wretched. About worry about no goddamn immigrants. Y'all support the immigrants. Feeling your head and feel that weed you got on your goddamn hair. You are immigrant. Rosetta, I bet you got some weave on your head right now. You went to the Arabians or Iranians or whatever the fuck they is. They trying to raise $5,000 in rooms or something like that. Yes, who is this?
My name is Deborah.
Your name is Officer Deborah. Deborah. Your name is Deborah.
I say Officer Deborah.
Okay. Were you on the scene?
No, I was not on the team.
So then, officer, how can you tell me what happened if you wasn't on the scene?
I don't know what happened. I just want to make a comment.
You said you want to tell me what... No, no, motherfucker, you on my officer. You ain't fuck, you ain't shit on, man, fuck you. Man, fuck you. You ain't no police on my, you ain't the police on my motherfucking show.
You can. Wait a minute, you must not know who I am.
Who, you said you're the police?
Not who I am, but who I is.
Well, who is you, motherfucker? What law? You're a security guard?
I'm not no motherfucking security guard. I'm a sheriff officer.
With who?
You got me fucked up, bitch.
You...
And I'm not no nigga, bitch.
Yeah, you're a nigga, bitch. You sound like a nigga, bitch.
With your soft, hard ass.
With my what?
You
just like
your mouth, bitch.
Just like your mammy.
I'm not no motherfucking security guard, ho.
You saw that you
with your
old B tag. I don't, man, I lost 40. You what now?
I said with your old B tag, bitch.
Now I used to be obese now. I done lost about 40 pounds. I'm fine now. Ask your wife. Ask your wife.
Wait a minute, you fine now?
Ask your... Okay. All right, Chef. If you...
You fine now.
If you are with the Chef of Cal... If you are...
Wait a minute.
Bitch.
Take up some of them steaks up in that boy's blood.
You ain't with the sheriff's department.
With your fine ass.
Yeah, you know I'm fine. Ask your wife.
With your old ass.
Well, I am old.
I know you old.
Mm-hmm.
Look at me while you, look at me while I'm talking to you. Look at me.
Motherfucker, I can't see you.
All right, look at me while I'm talking to you.
Motherfucker, I can't see you. You've been on the goddamn needles tonight, ain't you? Okay, bro.
I'm gonna be waiting out there.
Okay, bro. Oh, shit. Okay, bro. I be trying to get intelligent people to call me. That wasn't it, so. You're on that call server, aren't you? Oh, shit. If you a family member, y'all trying to raise $5,000. Y'all gonna raise $711. All right, if you're a family member and you want to put me in my place, so you don't agree with me, there's the number, 901-231-9239. $5,000 is a cheap funeral now. Y'all, where y'all gonna bury it? Man, I ain't scared to South Memphis. I'm not gonna stop telling the truth. Cause y'all don't like it. You gonna get mad. Y'all probably getting some t-shirts and gonna have a picture on the front. Y'all know, that's nigga shit. That is nigga shit. Getting you some t-shirts. Well, you need to get some t-shirts. I got somebody right here that can get you some t-shirts.
Do you need a custom designed t-shirt made for any occasion and you don't know where to go? Well, you want to call D2G Screenshots, owned by my good friend John Olam. John specializes in direct-to-garment printing. You can put anything on a t-shirt that you can take a picture of. You just snap it, send it, and wear it. No design is too hard for John. John will fix your t-shirts up in a matter of days and have it back to you. Whether it's for your business, whether it's for your community organization, whether it's for your girls' night out, whether you've got a motto or a theme that you want the world to know about. John Olam and D2G is the place to go. In fact, he's been doing the Cussing Pastor t-shirts now for a number of years, so I strongly recommend him. Call 279-0434, that's area code 901, 279-0434. John got you.
And if by chance you want to put her picture on a casket,
world famous Nashville casket sales is now serving Memphis and the surrounding areas. These legendary tribute caskets elevate any celebration of life ceremony. The sky's the limit on our completely customizable wrap caskets. From family photos to album covers, hobbies, our sports teams, we've got you. Let us create something special, memorializing your loved one in a way only Nashville casket sales can, at a cost half or more of any funeral home. Our caskets are accepted at every funeral home nationwide. Call our regional sales executive at 901-949-3000. That's 901-949-3000.
And if you need some programs and a headstone,
when death comes to your family and you're left in charge of putting together a celebration of life program, you want that program to be memorable, beautiful, and to project the marvelous life that your loved one lived. Well, for your funeral program, you don't have to search or look around. You just need to call the obituary queen, Dee Ferris, of Ferris Media and Marketing and Alpha Omega Monuments. Dee takes pride in special design and production of your loved one's memorable program. After the funeral and your loved one is buried, and you want that burial spot to be memorialized forever, call Dee for your monument. Dee Ferris and Ferris Media and Marketing Management can take care of all of your print needs, both church and professional, and anything that you need, Dee can get it done. You're looking for a graphic expert? Call Dee at 901-440-6643. That's 901-440-6643, or go by 2960 Chelsea at Wofford.
And so you won't have to start a GoFundMe.
So many of our young men and women are being killed on the streets of Memphis, and loved ones are left begging for a way to either bury or cremate them. Because while they have insured their cars and their phones, they have failed to insure themselves. Well, there is no excuse. Call Joe with Lincoln Heritage Funeral Advantage. Joe can get your loved one insured for $30,000 for as little as $15 per month. Or either if your loved one is a male between the ages of 18 or 25, he can be insured for $30 per month with a $160,000 accidental rider for only $30. Females, $25. Lincoln Heritage is affordable and has fixed rates. Lifetime coverage, no examinations, no waiting period on most cases. Coverage for all ages up to 100 years of age. Fast claim payments, 24 to 36 hours. Also, Joe has a senior hardship plan.
even for fixed income families. Call Joe right now. Make sure you put this number down. Joe with Lincoln Heritage, 901-864-0090. That's area code 901-864-0090. Call Joe.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And in case you got some bad tires on your car and you need to get to a film.
The biggest hazard to Memphis drivers other than car-to-car collisions is potholes. Well, you need a tire. You need to go to Tri-State Tire Wholesale, located at 3278 Democrat Road at American Way. They specialize in new and used tires. I don't care what it is that you drive, whether it's a car, a truck, tractor in the field, a motorcycle, SUV, or a semi-truck, Tri-State Tire Wholesale has the tire or tires for you at the best price in the Mid-South area. Every brand known to man is carried at Tri-State Tire Wholesale. Don't look anywhere else. Tri-State Tire Wholesale, 3278 Democrat Road at American Way. Call them at 901-795-0707. 901-795-0707.
And in case you need some inexpensive funeral clothes, go by Regroup.
Memphis and the surrounding areas, Regroup Upscale Thrift Boutique has opened in the heart of Frazier. We carry many name brands ranging from various sizes and styles, with new arrivals of clothing, accessories, gift items, and more, with pricing starting as low as $3. All the proceeds help empower the Husband Institute Boys Mentoring Program. So come and shop at Regroup Upscale Thrift Boutique, located at 3754 North Watkins. Great prices, great people, great products.
All right. I just don't say that. Don't be trying to help y'all. 18 minutes after the hour of 8 o'clock on a Friday night. Because all y'all trying to do is raise $5,000 for a funeral. Where y'all gonna bury it? Okay. Y'all can't take her to Memorial Park, and you can't take her up there, if especially in the neighborhood, to Calvary or Forest Hill. You're going to have to get some escorts. Please get your mama some flowers. I see people now don't get no flowers or nothing. I'm just trying to, my advertising can help you. I got people that can help you. And just in case y'all need to take a drink before the funeral, after the funeral.
Are you looking for a place to go on the weekends other than the club? Well, let me tell you about the newest hottest spot in town, and it's Martha's Daiquiri Festa, located at 8553 Macon in Cordova. Look, they have over 140 daiquiris. That's right, over 140 daiquiris. Plus, they got good food also. Look, you get daiquiris like the Drunk Jack Frost. The Pink Starburst, Strawberry Hennessy, the Lemon Drop Mango Whiskey Sour, Jungle Juice, and my favorite. And we're going to call it the Cussing Pastor Special. It's called Hideous Motherfucker. If you're tired of the kiddie atmosphere and you're grown and you want to be in a grown person's atmosphere, Martha's Daiquiri Factory is a place for you to be. Weekends, they've got big flat screen TVs. They've got a live disc jockey. They've got food. Martha's Daiquiri Factory, 8553 Lincoln in Cordova.
All right, I am back, okay? All right, 901-231-9239. Those of you that call me when I'm playing commercials, I don't answer the phone while the commercials are playing. Because the commercial period is the offering. Those of you that, Sunday morning, I'll be bringing a message on Sunday morning at 10 o'clock right here in my virtual church. So be here. Those of you who have gotten paid today and you think your little offering will be gone by Sunday, dollar sign, Naked Truth Ministries, okay? Yeah. Dollar sign, Naked Truth Ministries. Hello? 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 Stephanie, I was trying to answer you. Go ahead. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Hey, Daddy. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm alright. I'm Stephanie. I'm his red line sister.
Oh, okay. I didn't know she had no sister.
Got two of them.
You as pretty as she is.
Yeah. You have a neck and neck.
Hey, baby, who is you?
Hey,
Shanice, how you doing, baby?
I'm fine. How you doing tonight?
Baby, I'm just holding on, trying to make it to 9 o'clock.
I know. That's all you can do. But you tell it like, you tell me like it is tonight.
Yeah.
You're telling the doggone truth.
Didn't go want to have a GoFundMe.
Uh-huh. Oh, they want to have a GoFundMe?
Yeah, they're going to have a GoFundMe. They're trying to raise $5,000. Sell some fish. Sell some.
Hey, ain't nobody around here gonna tell it like you tell it.
No.
It is what it is.
Well, I don't know.
I really wish you could be mayor.
No, I'm gonna stick over here. They be trying to assassinate me and shit. Yeah, I'm a good security at the church too. I'm having good security at the church too.
Good. And you're looking good too.
Thank you, Shanice.
Mm-hmm. Looking good, Lord. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, I just wanted to tell you, I just moved here.
Mm-hmm.
And everything you on the screen saying, I'm seeing day by day.
Where do you come from?
Mississippi.
Lord, what part?
Clarksdale.
Oh, okay. Y'all ain't just roughing Clarksdale, are you?
You said you were there?
Y'all not just roughing Clarksdale, are you?
No, not this one. They run for Memphis.
What made you come to Memphis?
Well, I came up here for a job offer.
Okay.
You
living with Shanice?
No, I'm over here visiting her.
Oh, okay.
We were just talking about, you know, what we're saying. I'm telling her what I'm saying. And I watch the show all the time.
Well, thank you.
I'm up here now. I'm seeing it live action for myself.
Well, baby, we ain't got to be something in this city. I've never seen it in all my years. I've never seen Memphis like it is now. Yeah, you maybe should have stayed in Mississippi and drove up to take your little new job. Did you get the job?
Yeah, I
did. Okay. Well, be careful, baby. All right, baby. Thank you. Here.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it should stay in Mississippi, though. Woo. Stephanie. Okay. Zena. Be still, baby. Okay. I'm a bit off in a little bit. Oh. You're hungry. Oh, she needs your husband and gonna let you go to Clarksdale. Yeah, he may want to go too long. All right, 901-231. 9239. Okay. 901-231-9239. Hey, Amber. How you doing? You have a day today? Mm-hmm. Yes. All right. 901-231. 9239. What time is it? Oh, 8:30. This is a mess. If you as a parent you and your children shit, flush yourself. Wipe yourself and flush yourself. This lady would not be dead. If she had used parent skills. But she probably didn't have parent skills. Okay? But this is what happens when you all lay down, fuck, and get babies early in life. You ain't gonna keep it in the streets. Pussy, you call the police every time. Yes, I call the police. I will call the police on you, motherfucker. Yes. Or shoot you. I'm an undertaker by trade. I grew up at N.J. Fold and Sons. I like dead peoples. And I don't mind making you one of them. Hallelujah. Okay? But something has got to happen. The police should arrest everybody that's out there. Virginia, thank you. This Sunday morning, I'll be back here, baby. I'm going to have a sermon at 10 o'clock Sunday morning. All y'all join me Sunday morning. If you want to get your luck, set your ass down, Zena. I love you too, but please be still. Lay down. Lay down all the way down. All the way. Some people actually love their kids. You hate yours. You won't protect yours. No. I ain't getting no children shit. Nope. I am. No. See, that's just like you ignorant ass mamas that will put your goddamn house up to get a motherfucker out of jail. This motherfucker been selling dope. He been carjacking. And you know he do that shit. By the time he calls you all kinds of bitches and hoes and shit, and then time the police lock his ass up, no. You gonna come get me out. And here your stupid ass put your house up. And I'm talking to some motherfuckers right now that's been ignorant in the past. And you done put your goddamn house up for a dumb motherfucker that you know is a goddamn thief. You know he ain't no good. But you run, go get him a lawyer. If you're a dope dealer and can't afford a lawyer, he needs to be selling cars, jacks, baseball cards, any goddamn thing. He don't need to be selling no goddamn dope, and he ain't got no lawyer money. He ain't got no bond money. He should have some money put up in a fund that if he go to jail, you can go and get it out. And get him out and bond him out with his own money. this is the sickening shit. You know, we showed that film some other week where they were fighting at the school. They jumped on the girl. If his ass is a criminal, let him deal with the consequences of his shit. Well, damn well.
See that? There they go. The fight is on. Don't break them up now. Let them fight. Let them fight. Don't mess with them.
Everyone got a pistol.
Mama got a pistol out there with some kids. See? Mess ass shit. Mess as fuck.
He got a pistol too.
Everybody got a pistol. They just as messy as fuck. Messy as fuck. Messy as fuck. And here come one with a sword. I guess that's a sword. Oh, machine. They messy as fuck.
Hey, Sean, you shot him, man. You killed him. He killed
the girl. Yes, it's fuck. Yes, it's fuck. Y'all just mess as fuck.
What's your ass in the house?
Let me get my girl.
See, and that ain't the first time that little girl done fired up. Oh, go on, here you go. See, instead of Congress getting rid of TikTok, they need to get rid of GoFundMe. That's what they need to get rid of. Somebody says she fired the gun like James Bond. She knew what she was doing. And she told police the gun accidentally went off. Mm-hmm. She thinks this is in South Memphis on Quinn, off of South Parkway, and over in the Hamilton High School area. Don't ask me what we're going to do. I don't know. Y'all need to stop having babies. Quit fucking. That's what you need to do. Stop fucking. And the folk that was doing the commentary, they didn't run. No. Shots going off all around them, and they just filming. hands wasn't shaking, the camera wasn't shaking. Shit, they used to that shit on that street. But this is life in the hood. Some of you want to live in the hood. I want to be by my people. I don't want to live. You kind of niggas, I don't want to live next to you. Mm-mm. You parking your car on the grass type ass niggas. Basketball goal in front of the house ass niggas. Mechanics in the driveway ass niggas. Drying your clothes on the front porch ass niggas. Sheets to the window ass niggas. Sleeping on mattresses that ain't got no bed ass niggas. You niggas, I don't want to be around. Yeah, somebody said, couch and wash on from for. It's been a long time since I've seen that. The couch and the washing machine on the front porch. Ooh. Many of you niggas, I don't want to live by. I'm sorry, that hurts your fucking feelings. I'm just like the white peoples. They don't want to live about you. I'm in a mixed neighborhood. Some white peoples and some black peoples. But we don't have nothing on this street. Yes, that's them lowering your property value ass niggas. Mm-mm. Them no cutting their grass ass niggas. You want to say, I already got a GoFundMe up for $5,000. That's a cheap ass funeral. Undertaker ain't gonna get no joy out of that one. Lord, hundreds. The Lord post that they sent me shows they raised $711. That ain't gonna get you no grave. See, you gotta get a grave. You gotta get a vault. Unless you go out there to Eternal Peace out in Milton, Black Home Cemetery. You know, you just dump the casket in the hole. About 4 feet out of eternal peace, or is it eternal rest? It's eternal somebody out there in Milton. But she committed suicide. Hello? Hello? They should took it down to the throne room at 695 and go to the fire. Hello?
To accept, press 1. To send a voicemail, press 2.
Yes, who is this? Who is this? A bitch ass nigga that don't know your name? $5,000, get your good cremation. And if you burn it up, at least get a vase or urn to put the ashes in. Don't let the funeral home just put in a Ziploc. I've seen it in my homes where y'all cremate your loved peoples and y'all even come back to get the cremains. They just come on back to the funeral home. What time is it? Yeah, 2 minutes to 9. So you're not seeing any news on Facebook from me until Friday. Okay? They didn't like the video. All right, you keep calling me. Who the fuck is this? I'm sucking your mama's titty ass, motherfucker. Shit. Yeah. Alright. I'm finna get out of here, shit. I'm tired. Oh, I'm tired. Yeah. You go. I don't know. Garland is on the takeover in Arkansas. So they don't come back and get... Why y'all don't go back and get your mama them big mama them? Okay. Y'all don't go back to get the big... Go back and get big mama. She in the bag. Y'all been warm, Grandmama, then. Y'all been rented a casket and pretend y'all got some burial, some grave money. And people be at the church and they don't know that the casket is rented. And, they shall be putting Miss Betty away good. No, they burn up Miss Betty, okay? They burn up Miss Betty. That oven is 1,100 degrees. It burns your bones. Zeno, yeah, she wants to play floor runner. Let me, this motherfucker here. Let me just stop this motherfucker. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go. I just don't like you. I'm just, people be saying that about me. And I'm such a nice person. Well, all this fuck you shit. Kiss my ass and call it sweet.
Sing my song, y'all. You can hate on me, but I'm still gonna do my thing. You can hate on me, guarantee you gon' still remember my name. You can hate on me, yeah, I know you don't like me, no. You hate on me, I guarantee you gon' still remember my name. Nobody's perfect, yeah. There's one thing everybody forget. They try to walk around like this shit don't stink. That's why I keep my head down and sip my drink. Nobody's perfect. That's one thing everybody forget. They try to walk around like this shit don't stink. That's why I keep my head down and sip my drink. You can hate on me, but I'm still gon' do my thing. You can hate on me, guarantee you gon' still remember my name. You can hate on me, yeah, I know you don't like me, no. I know I probably called you out your name, but I never would be.
Should've never put my hand up.
You can call me a man,
call me a man.
You can call me a preacher,
you can call me a preacher.
I know you didn't like when I put you on game, but I still had to teach you.
Still had to teach you.
I should've never called Keisha,
never called Keisha.
Now that girl is trouble. She put it all on me. Hit her one time, then I had to go back for double. You can hate on me, but I'm still gon' do my thing. Time you see a hater, I look him in the eye and say, until you do right by me, please get out of my face. I don't call my phone, I don't leave me a text message. I'ma send your ass to voicemail, by now you should get the message.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You can hate on me, but I'm still gon' do my thing. You can hate on me, guarantee you gon' still remember my name. You can hate. I know you don't like me, no. You hate on me. I guarantee you gon' still remember my name. I'm here to tell you, you can hate on me,
hate on me.
You can hate on me,
hate on me.
I really don't care,
hate on me.
You can hate on me. I don't call my phone.
If you wanna go. Show.